it should actually break it up. And then if I go here and actually look at my VODs, I should have one video that's that and another video that's that. All right, cool. Now I know that works, and hopefully that'll actually get rid of some of the higher CPU latency that I'm seeing. Hey Nick, are you nearby? Nick? Hey.
Hey.
Hey buddy. Oh boy, you are barely holding anything. That is about to change.
Well, see what I can do.
Thank you, sir. But yeah, now that I know that... Oops. Now that I know that that works, I'm actually going to start doing that on my longer casts. And that would help if I was making sort of... If I was actually making episodic content, that would be a really quick and easy way to be like, hey, here's episode one. Beep, boop. And then start it again. Here's episode two. Beep, boop. So, to me, that's good. That was good. Even if it was a small thing... Oh no, brother. Brother. Is that all there is for this place? I feel like there should be more. Is there anything on the other side, or is the other side... I think the other side just sort of leads to the same spot. Unless there's a doorway. Alright, so that doesn't go anywhere. And this ramp just sort of leads to that. Alright, that's fine. I can turn around. Xbox free! Dude! How's it going? You just missed something very fascinating happening, which is sort of story related. Oh god. No, the minigun, that is one of the things that's like, you know that they're trying to be like, this shit's awesome. When they give you a minigun in like the second fucking mission once you're outside of the vault. What is this? Custom House Tower. As you can see, I've been busy exploring this entire area, which is just abso-fucking-lutely packed with somebody. Somebody got Shrek'd. Is that what they just... Yeah. Alright, well, that's not bad. Let's keep going this way. You mean the white screen down there? Why the fuck was that happening? That shouldn't be happening, because, that's the, alert box. That's the follower notification thing. Search the area. Hi. Yeah, I haven't rented video games in a really long time. Like, I had to have been in either middle school or high school the last time I actually rented a game. Jesus. Yes. Shamrock Tap House. Well, I found my thing. Where is that light at? Oh, I didn't think that was actually gonna hit him. I mean, I'll take those. What? Christmas is about 2 weeks away? Yeah, that sounds about right. Hey, Nick. Nick.
Hey.
There you go, everybody. Alright, so I kind of thought that might happen. Can you actually just... Can you hold this?
Dumping for you?
That'll actually hold us off. Just don't go firing that thing on your own. Randomly, some Mirelurks showed up in the area. I will completely reap the benefits of the fact that they were fighting Mire. Oh, God, excuse me, Mirelurks earlier. Before I even got here. Now, don't tell me you got high encoding now. There should be... The file should be tiny at this point. Alright. So this little place right here, the Shamrock Tap House, is the entire reason we're here. Well, I mean, I can assume that it's because you're going to be getting gifts and goodies, as do, like, damn near everybody that does Christmas. So it's a good reason to want Christmas. Oh. You guys don't see me yet?
Hearing shit.
How about you, Gaff?
Someone's coming.
Oh, hey! Listen, it is fair game if it is not hidden well enough. But congrats on the 360, man! There is a giant library of really good games on that on there. Poking your head out enough for me? No. You wanna poke your head out there a smidge? Hi there, little friend. Boop. Thank you. You're not a...
Only a fucking coward hide.
Listen, I ain't hiding. You're hiding. That didn't work.
What's that?
Mm. Don't you try that sneaking up behind me bullshit. I bet you could. Get him, Nick! Get him! Hey. Yeah, no, I could stream Fallout 3.
Take a look.
Actually, I don't know. Is that visible on camera? So you see the backpacks down here? There's a second backpack sort of towards the back of the wall corner right there. My 360's in that. At this point in my life, though, my 360 is more of... it has one purpose and one purpose only. Which is, it plays You Don't Know Jack for me. Alright, you didn't have anything good. Alright, can we just get rid of some armor? I have to be stocked up on, like, shit tons of armor that I'm just never gonna use. Oh, God, excuse me. I used to. I actually used to have Xbox Live Gold. Back before I, was this a... What? I mean, sure. Back before I got, wow, my brain just literally shut itself down. Back before, I actually had my own laptop or anything else like that, I was always a console gamer. Everything I played was on consoles. Because it's just what I had the easiest access to.
I'm all ears.
Alright, so we are officially out of space on Nick. So we get to... I see you there. So, like, I don't know, probably for the first, like, 16, 17 years of my life, I was a console gamer. I still am a console gamer, but 9 times out of 10, if I can get something on Steam, nice. I will buy it on Steam rather than try to deal with... Oh, where the fuck were you? Stick, noodle cup, purified water. That should be enough to sort of follow me out. I don't know how the hell I didn't see it. I tried looking for it, but I completely missed it. Oh, fuck you too. But no, that's just sort of how I feel that works. If you're, like, I was never graced with a PC that was good enough to run PC games until I had to convince my parents to buy a laptop for when I was, going to college. So, once it became... Oh, I need a laptop to go that I'm going to college, and there's minimum specs on it, and the minimum specs actually... You probably wanted to exceed the minimum specs in most cases. It was a really easy sell to sort of get them to, you know... Get me a PC that was good. and that I could actually run stuff with. Oh! Well, hi there! Safe? But to actually get back to your point, I'm pretty sure I have Fallout 3 on... I'm pretty sure I have Fallout 3 on Steam on my PC. So... I could stream it, and I've thought about streaming it. Must say, I just thought about the fact that, wait, am I really that far over? Holy shit. So yes, to answer your question, I can. I do sort of... Nothing amazing in here. Besides the new Colas. Heaviest thing I have that I don't plan to keep. God, it's so much value. I have such a hard time getting rid of it. Alright, so we don't need you. Don't need you. You. That actually puts us down. Alright. But yeah, that's sort of how that goes with, like, excuse me. Colas, I don't need colas. Come on. It's like right there. Yeah.
Got it.
Oh, hi, Nick. I didn't know you were there. I actually don't think you have the room to lug anything anymore. Or at least that's what I was led to believe. Fucking mole rats. Mm-mm. You back up off my dick. I mean, I will take your delicious meat.
Barely see a thing.
All right, let's look at the actual terminal here. Experimentation logs. God damn it. That's a third set of gasket seals it's blown off this week. The whole damn thing is full of mash water again. The first batch always works like a charm, but if you have to pop the chassis open every couple of days to replace the gaskets, no one is going to want to buy one of these things. Wonder if the cultures are retaining more heat due to the flash fermentation process. That extra heat could be what's causing the problem. I reworked the design to move the thermal exchanger so the coils wrap around the bottling siphon And that seems to have done the trick. Not only the gasket's not melting, but it also cools the beer bottles in it. Ice cold. Every time. One of my patrons also gave me a lead on a possible investor. Jack West, the manager over at Hotel Rexford, apparently just came into an inheritance and he could front the cash I need to get the Drinking Buddy into full production. He's agreed to my terms if I let him run the prototype at the hotel for a month to drum up additional press. Mr. West has run into a slight problem in that the hotel is contractually obligated to only serve Gwinnett beer. So I can't use my own recipes. Luckily, I know a guy who knows a guy who has cracked the encryption on their proprietary brewing holotapes. So we put that code into the subroutines for now. It's risky if Gwinnett's lawyers catch wind, but hopefully it's just a stopgap until we can get into production or work something out with them. West is really starting to get on my nerves. First, it's the hang up with the recipes. Now he says the Drinking Buddy looks too impersonal. That's a typing error right there. Impersonal? What a pompous ass! I told him that the brewing vat need there is no room for the servos needed to simulate a face, and that idiot asked me to just put some gouges out on the front like they were eyes. I'm gonna deliver it to the theater during intermission on Friday, and he'll just have to get over it. Getting to the Rexford might be tricky. The body could probably take a direct hit from a truck, but the leg servos on those protectatrons are wicked slow. Maybe I'd better rent a truck. I'll stash the boot up password here in the basement till I can get the delivery sorted out. Well, I can unlock it. You watching, Nick? I got this. Standard wreckage approach. Lunatics thriving. Damn. All right, let's see. Speakers. Preserve? ER? Creating? There it is!
Hey buddy, I found a recipe for you.
Complete. Dispensing sample for approval by technician. How would you describe the testing sample provided?
What are you?
I am a modified Robco Protectron designated Drinking Buddy. My internal microbrewers allows for the internal brewing, bottling, and dispensing of beer at an accelerated rate. I am also programmed to tell a wide variety of jokes for the customer's amusement.
Jokes, you say?
How would you describe the testing sample provided?
Cold and refreshing. Do you know how long it's been since I had cold beer?
Very good. I appear.
Sure.
Shall we commence delivery to the Hotel Rexford?
We're not gonna be assholes.
Yeah, sure.
Beginning transit operations to Hotel Rexford.
Oh, I didn't notice this end. This would have been a shortcut. Yeah, it's some just robot who's like, yeah, I'll literally make whatever beverage you want, and it'll be ice cold and refreshing every time. Oh no, this already seems like it's going to be... You're gonna fall, aren't you? You did it, buddy. Okay, one, where the fuck are we? We have a ways to go to get the Good Neighbor. Oh, God, excuse me. Only my buddy here would move a smidge faster. Uh-oh. Is that literally Good Neighbor, like, right there? Certainly is not.
Approach and identify yourself. Law-abiding citizens will not be harmed.
I don't see anybody. Oh, Robo Buddy, you went a different way. Oi, 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 oi. I didn't mean to pick up his sledgehammer. I also didn't mean to drop that thing. I wanted to drop you. Is that actually somebody? Yeah, it is. I thought so. Wow. We need to find our way up there, so... How in the hell are we getting up there? What is this place? Hub 360. Alright, that shouldn't be too hard to remember. Do I actually have a... His robot has done gone six kinds of crazy. Closer to be the good neighbor. Oh, we're like right there. So he's probably gonna take the right here and then run up that way. God, that means they're really fucking close to good neighbor. That's good to hear, at least. If only he moved a little slower than a fucking snail space. Or faster than a snail space. How are you getting to where you need to go? Oh god, alright, so we can get rid of some stuff to... I don't know, it's because you're trying to kill me? Seems like a perfectly valid reason to do that. Alright, where are you, little buddy? Oh my god, this thing moves so fucking slow. Here. We're getting there. Shit. Oh, God. I hate when I stress myself like that. There it goes. Jeez. I've been trying to put that fucking odd, like, custom marker down for a good bit, actually. Oh my god, we finally got him down to a good neighbor. Dude. Don't. Please, for the love of god, do not start glitching out on me right now. You first, buddy. We haven't really been using the Protectatrons. I gotta imagine there's a decent thing to say. But there's probably some good way to build, like, okay, I'm gonna take... Basically all the stuff that doesn't matter. No, that's what the fuck am I trying to say here? So while I sit here and wait for the damn thing to actually come to me. Wow, my brain just fucking short-circuited. I have no idea where I was going with that. No, for me, it's pretty much going to be, we're going to do this quest, and then we're donezo. We don't. Damn. But yeah, we're gonna do this and we're done for the night, because I am getting tired. I'm getting to the point where it's actually hard to think and concentrate. Excellent. Oh boy, what is this? What is this thing, Vic? What have you done? Yes, it does. I don't know how the hell you get to that point, but yes, it does. Actually, there is one more thing I want to do, and that'll be the thing I end the night on. We're gonna go back to the Cabot House. Now, note, I just leveled up. I haven't spent the point yet. But I already know where it's going. Son of a bitch. I am so sorry that I'm yawning as much as I am. I honestly should have taken a nap when I got home from work today. Couple of nights during the week where I was just like, I am not getting my 6 hours of sleep. Because 6 is about when I need to function properly during the day and not crash early. Admittedly, I'm crashing later than I normally would, but it's still a crash that is happening that I probably could have avoided had I, you know, taking that nap. Taken. So it's not terrible, it's just it happens. Every once in a while. I will just end up having to, like, because of a combination of factors, either I went to sleep too late or I woke up in the middle of the night and had my sleep interrupted or something. The thing is upstairs, right? How the fu- Oh, did I- Well, that is all of that unread, and I don't feel like going back and reading it. Son of a bitch. Oh well. We haven't heard from Jack for a week. He and Edward made it to Parsons, at least. Jack radioed when they arrived. Tried to be cheerful as usual, put on a happy face for Imogene. But who really knows if they're going to manage? At least Edward is with him. If anyone can get through this, it's Edward. Yeah, I must have just forgot to unmute myself when I coughed the last time. There's a lot of these. Jack made it back finally. He says Edward is very sick from radiation. He left him at Parsons. I don't think he expects him to live. I'm not sure why neither of us is sick. I was out quite a lot, now that I think about it. Maybe another of the benefits of Jack's magic serum. I'll have to thank Father for that the next time I see him. Also, thank you for the catch, Vic. I didn't even notice it. It turns out that eventually, even the apocalypse can get boring. Jack and Edward are too good at keeping us safe. It looks like the Cabot family is immune from the end of the world, just like everything else. We'll just shrug it off and keep going, just like we always have. Sometimes I'm very pleased about that. It makes me feel incredibly superior. Sometimes it makes me really, really sad. Most of the time, it's just boring as hell. I stopped even telling anyone where I'm going. The world isn't as dangerous as Jack says. There's still people living out there, living their lives, like they always have. I guess more of them are willing to kill you now, but that's probably just because they can. I always got the feeling that plenty of people would have liked to see us dead before. They just couldn't get away with it. I don't know how Jack keeps himself busy day after day. You'd think he would realize that it was hopeless by now, after all these years and years. Maybe he's just going through the motions, the way I am. The way I am? Or maybe he's stopped trying to cure Father. I mean, what happens after? To us? I'm the one that's ever tried to go out without the serum. Maybe Jack and Mother could think they could just give it up. But I'm pretty sure they're fooling themselves. That was a little unfortunate. Yeah, that was... I try to be careful about making sure that I unmute my mic when I do shit like that. But that's... Oh. Hey.
Hi. What's up?
You're back. Holy shit. Alright. I think we're going to do our last drop off of the night over in Sanctuary. Go ahead and get that taken care of. And then I think we're done for the night. We don't have anything else to do. Or anything else I want to do. See, now I don't have to worry about lockpicks anymore, because I mean they're gonna burn some bobby pins, but I don't have to worry about lockpicks. I can get into pretty much any terminal that doesn't require a MacGuffin to get me in. So we are actually slowly running out of things to give talent points to. Although I imagine there's things I could easily do for talent to put talent points in.
Look alive.
Go ahead. If I got it.
I wish there was a faster way to do this. I wish I could go to a tab and be like, take everything in the tab. Not, take everything he has. Wow, he...
Not getting anywhere.
He really doesn't have a lot of... Wow, my brain has short-circuited again. I had no idea where I was going. Sort of drop everything down. Pretty much dropping it. No, God, no. Is it? Let's see here. That can easily be put away. That all stuff can be put away. You too. Oh, what am I doing?
Look at the two of us here in.
Yeah, about that.
Sanctuary. Preparing for the future.
So we're gonna do what we always do. Is we're gonna make two saves and then we are done for the night. Oh, you can even see in my posture that I'm slouching because I'm getting tired. So, let me get you guys some music going. We can go with that. So, that is it for me tonight, guys. I'm out of here. We got a bunch of stuff done. The fucking railroad people showed up when I wasn't even intending to sort of follow that quest, but that happened. We got the beer bot buddy back, and we did some other stuff. We also helped to kill a man who was being controlled by an ancient artifact on top of his head. But that's neither here nor there. So tomorrow will be more casts. I don't know exactly when I'm going to start up. I'll try. If I can nail down a time, it'll probably be tweeted out. But otherwise, it'll just be sometime after lunch. And I'll be casting for most of the day anyway. So, that's everything. Pretty sure that's everything. Yeah. All right, so guys, for everybody that hung out with me and stuck around, I want to thank you. You guys are awesome. You make going through a lot of this stuff really better, even better than the initial version to just the base game. If you have not followed me and you are enjoying yourself, please do make kind of hit the follow button over in that corner over there. That'll let you know when I go live. It'll let me know that you're enjoying yourself and that things are going pretty well. You can follow me on Twitter. My Twitter link is down below. I tweet out when the stream goes live, and then I will tweet things occasionally. It's not a high volume tweeting account, so you don't have to worry about that. You can also find my YouTube channel link down below. That is where all of my preview parts are archived. That's where today's video is going to go up as soon as I'm basically offline. I'm going to start the upload process. You can also find, past playthroughs and all of my highlights mirrored up there. That's everything. So before I go, I need you guys to do me a kindness. I want you guys to have a good day, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good night, whatever it happens to be, wherever you are at. And I will see you guys tomorrow. Later.